Guys, it's May 3rd. It's kind of a tough day for me. Because it's May 3rd. And I'm Hispanic. So I should be downtown, but it's not safe to go there at night because it gets a little rowdy, but I was a little sad about that, but I got through it. But I want to tell you about my stop at the organic store. I had an issue with some leaves. And they had like five professionals there. These guys are on the radio. They're experts, old school. And I had some yellowing on the leaves. I was so concerned. And then on the beans as well. And I researched it, and there's so many different opinions. So I asked these guys, took the leaves down there. I was like, what's going on? And they said, nothing. Yeah. He said, your plants look really great. I mean, they're awesome. And that the yellow spot is probably a lack of feed. So he said, I want you to do this. Use this product, which I probably could have made on my own. No product endorsement. And she said, do it now. Do it at this point in very trace amounts at every watering for your fruits and vegetables. But I'm not growing fruit, so. And then I got this for free. No product endorsement, of course. And I don't know if I'll use it because I'm non-GMO, vegan, no gluten. You know, I'm just a weirdo. Like, I don't necessarily know if I want fish, but it's just one of those things where you have to make a decision what's right or wrong for you and your vegetables and the investment of time. So today on the Cinco de Mayo, third sad day, they have to be watered tonight. So I'm going to start initiating that product because I don't have this time to make the kelp tea. And, you know, I didn't know about it, so you know, sometimes you just gotta fly by the seat of your pants. And I got a discount. And I went into a raffle to get some a free angel fountain. That's cool. And you can take your pick. It's like these really high-end products that you can win on a raffle. I probably won't win. I got bad luck. But anyway, so I want to stop and get a book. Remember I told you guys about that? And by the way, the shower didn't happen last night. As you can see the circles. I was up all night adjusting the garden because I took care of my best friend's garden when she went away. And she had a present fungus already, and I knew it. And I tried to correct it, and there was just, we barely got any seeds to germinate. So, barely. It was like soil deprivation, dry as a bone. Seeds had been in there for 7 days, and they weren't doing anything. There was not a good quality vermiculite. It wasn't a light soil. There was just so many issues. And I don't think anybody could have saved that. I mean, it was just mold. Out of control, trying to fix it, and it wasn't cool. But I did get a book. But it's a trip. No product endorsement. But this was written. It was a New York Times bestseller. Yeah, here's a receipt, $4. So funny. And Joan LaFost of the New York Times wrote it, and she was a part of the botanical garden. Check out that picture, man. That is so old school. And I love old school. This was written, and it was just so cool. This book is so cool. I was going to school to be a librarian, so I love books. In 1975, that's hardcore, and it's called The Book of Vegetable Gardening. Yes. What's cool about this book is it's simple and to the point. It's like rutabaga. Shows you what it looks like, what its seed looks like, what it looks like in the mid stage, and then at harvest, which. You know, we don't know. Beginners don't know. We're just taking a flying flip and leap. germination, soil, varieties, where to grow, how to grow, culture, harvest, pests, diseases. See? That's the stuff we're always thinking about when you get to this level. There's a Chinese cabbage, which I'm growing. Yes. Chinese cabbage. There's the baby. There's the mid. There's the harvest. Bok choy and wang bok. Mad love for the Chinese vegetable. And she says here, it's so funny, Brassica chinensis. Pekinensis. And it says there are two forms, what is known as Chinese cabbage, bok choy, which grows more like a chard than a cabbage and has oblong, shiny green leaves on swollen white stems. And wang bok. So cool. Which suggests, oh, don't let me do any damage on the language. I probably messing that all up. A lettuce with its long, compact head with crinkled leaves at the outer edges. They're annuals. They're interesting in Chinese cookery. Are becoming increasingly popular, and some gourmets prefer these cabbages for slaw and cooking to the head ties. I mean, that's stuff that, like, I don't even know if you get that nowadays. Like, it's just bad, but, man, just rock star. Where to grow? Varieties. There's, like, crispy, hybrid. There's all kind of crazy. Planting. Midsummer for fall. How? The seeds should be sown directly in the ground in rows of 2.5 inches apart. Plants thin to 16 inches, you know what I mean? Like, it's just so comprehensive on one page. Harvest 2.5 to 3 months. When heads feel compact and firm there, they should be cut off. Pests, same as for cabbage. Diseases, same as for cabbage. Man, that's the information that we need. Like nitrogen, calcium, what's it all about? I like our hands-on stuff. Like, look at these pics. That's just some old-school madness. Transplant have enemies. Cutworms and slugs. Where they have been a problem in the past, be wary and take precautions. You know, it's in the letters are really big for me who has glasses. I don't need that fine print, man. Don't give me all unnecessary information. Just drives me batty. I'm a micromanager. And I got that IQ, you know? So it's like, it kicks my butt. I like this old school basket. Look at that. Man, that's just rock star on every level. And then she goes through, like, this was like cutting edge like back then. You know, fluorescent light fixtures. You know, she was on her game. As soon as the weather settled down and nights are warm, tomato seedlings can be set outdoors. An old muffin tin. That's cool, man. You know how many muffin tins I have? Like a million. I'm sure some stuff might say, don't use the muffin tins. But, you know, man, she's got it in a muffin tin. For life of, come on, man. That's just on a whole new level of simplicity. It's just, my God. Fill these clean containers with vermiculite to the depth of several inches and use a separate container for each kind of seed. That's where I've blown it before, remember? By tapping at the end of the packet. Cover it well with a thin layer of vermiculite. You know, just her choice of words. They get to the point. And then the tools you're going to need. Strings and stakes and metal and hoe and cultivator and watering can. pH. pH requirements of vegetables. Look at that information. Man, I'm just so blown away by this $4 book. That way I don't have to bug Praxis and, you know, a plethora of other people, man. I just bug you to death. Inorganic fertilizers and organic. Phosphorus, potassium carriers, nitrogen. You can use Coke. Nobody told me that. Nobody told me. Maybe not Coke from now, because like back in the day it had like real, you know what, bad stuff, which was never my fertilizer facts, where nutrients come from, the big six. It's just so comprehensive and beautiful. I love these pictures. And I look through, you know, why grow your own, getting started, soil, plant nutrition, mulching, composting, weeds, watering, what to do about bugs. I'm sure everything isn't, you know, like appropriate for nowadays because there's probably something newer. But man, I love Joan Foss. It's really cool at the back of the book. It has all the names. And it has every single company that you can contact, which I probably have to send a letter, which means I do stamps, which we don't do anymore. And it's all at the universities, horticultural. That's so cool. And then she shows you what the bugs look like. Nice. You know, instead of people just hit me up with all kinds of information, and then she goes into the mints, and man, now I want to grow some other stuff. Turnips. I mean, tomatoes. How to line them up. Like, she uses a stick, a string, three tomato plants, connect them, and then support the stem, and then put another piece of wood on there. Yeah, that's ideas. There's caging, which was like back then, it was like, woo. Where to grow, how it grows, what a tomato plant does. The tomato is a vigorous plant, a heavy feeder with attractive foliage resembling the potato, its cousin. The plants have a decided odor caused by gland hairs on the stems and leaf, which give off a strong scented oil and stain. Now look at where broken. Check this out. All those plants that I thought were chilies, they're not chilies. All of those are tomatoes. So I think Cindy's got enough tomatoes going on here because he got that furry thing. I knew that furry thing was something. But you know what I mean? Like, I don't know what a tomato plant looks like. So help me. Because I made such a bad mistake. There are two types. The determinant, which is genetically controlled where terminal buds set fruit and stop the plant from growing. Do not need stalking. And the indeterminate. See, I've been looking up determinant, indeterminate, and it wasn't hitting my IQ. I'm creatively high up there in IQ. But I'm not scientifically smart. But I learn real quick. So this kind of information, I think, is imperative. I'm going to do a plug on this one because, God, this is crazy. Look at their photos. Isn't that cute? It's called Book of Vegetable Gardening. And you know, at the thrift store, they had a dollar book. Like, everything you need to know about gardening. And I was going to get them the other day, like a week ago. So I was shopping for some other stuff. Because I'm always looking for bottles and jars and all this stuff. And because I like to save money, man. My husband makes good money, but I mean, I don't work, you know, professional student. So, you know, all these things are important. And for every little thing, she explains it in a very, very, very simplistic manner. And I'm excited today. I found out that my beans are fine. The tomato leaves just need some food, you know, because the soil. See, I didn't know the difference between potting soil and like stuff outside. And today he explained to me, he said, it's this simple. Outside, it needs a heavier soil, for those of you that don't know, because I didn't know. I mean, I knew there was differences, the bags, but I didn't know why. So it's a heavier soil, it retains more moisture, and it feeds it better. And I knew a lady who put molasses down. It was her secret tomato growing. And I have vegan, organic molasses. So that's the way I'm going to go with these tomatoes when I move them. I'm going into molasses. I might start putting a little in there now on a couple test bunnies. So I got my grow big stuff. It's got nitrogen, phosphate, potash, K2O, magnesium, boron, copper, iron, magnesium, and zinc. General feeding is 2 to 3 teaspoons per gallon of water every other watering. She said, I do it every time I water. Reduce that down in a very big way. And I want you to give them all your vegetables and stuff that. And she said, I grow them every year. I don't cage them. I support the stock. And if you're going to cage them, do it now. See, I don't like that caging thing. Now, later I come back on another video and say, okay, that was a bad idea. But I'm going to try to not do it. Because I had an idea. Here I go again. To create a square bamboos. Because you can get those large bamboo sticks. I'm going to get one just so you can see it. I have them from last year. These bamboo sticks. And I don't waste anything. Waste not, want not. That's the school I come from. They're dry and they're hard. I can buy these for less than probably a penny. And I want to get this and another one and some hemp string on different levels and support that stock. I know tomatoes like to spread, but I don't have the room. That is the issue. No room outside. And I'm doing flowers for Save the Bee thing and the what? Because I need the cross-pollination. That's a whole nother video. I want to use these. Call me crazy. Call me whatever you like. But I'm looking at her book and there's some good suggestions for supporting those tomatoes. Now, tomatoes are just one thing. That it's not the plethora of other things. Like onion. That's important. My jalapenos are important. They're in my diet every day. And I want to pickle and jar them. Cabbages, kimchi. Come on. Let's go. Stir fry. That could be done every day. Collard greens, kale. I can't tell you how much I spend for kale. Big bag. It lasts me 2 days. I burn right through it. You know, I've lost 50 pounds. Yeah, 50 pounds. Just since I've been vegan, which you guys can eat meat. That's cool. But for me, no. I wanted to do it and I wanted to change my life. So, everybody's happy. I posted a video last night of how everybody was happy and is happy. If you get those lights too close before maturity, you're going to have problems. If they're nice and lush and green and furry, you're doing good. If they get yellow spots, feed them. They need more nutrition. They're a heavy feeder. See, there's lingo there that we get thrown all the time as beginners, and we don't know what they're talking about. What's a heavy feeder? So we Google it. Then somebody says this over here. No. Who's right? It's like this in your brain. So I post these videos for beginners. I might not be a beginner. I think I'm on top of most things. So I'm going to try this feeder, and I checked with a pro on the AM radio. These guys have been gardening for like 30 years. These spots are not, they're not caused from that. They have a lack of food. He said, in general, with vegetables, whenever you see those spots and the rest of the plant's fine, you're okay. They need food. And then I threw every other possible question. Chilies, this, that, this, that, this, that. He said, steak it. Steak it. I got all the stuff for staking. Why not? Let's do it. Let's try it. I staked. We made a teepee for the beans. We did. Hemp string and small bamboo. I'm going to try it. I'm excited. It's hot in here. It's hot. I'm thirsty. I went listening to the mariachis and everything. It was cool. So germination, I'm looking now. Stuff's starting to poke out. It hasn't been 24 hours. Everything looks super dry right now. I like going dry. Leave it there for a day. Just let it be thirsty. Let it be thirsty. And when you water, this is the best advice I ever got. Water around. See how dry that is? It's dry. Because tonight's feeding time. Now it's searching. It's building roots. That's what we want. So the roots are searching for the water. But if I throw cold water on there, no, 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 no. Use tepid, warm. And don't get water on here. Don't do it. Don't damp off thing. Whatever that means, the damping off thing. I don't do that. Wind, for sturdiness. This is a tomato. Look at how happy she is. I should name them all. God, you know how many names I have? It's like Isabella. So this is my tomato. Yeah, it's healthy, it's happy, it's in a cup. I'll use the same cups next year. You're gonna see videos next year. But I'm not gonna use those big words. No matter how advanced I get. I keep it simple. K-I-S-S. Kiss. Keep it simple. And my collard greens are doing great. Kale's doing great. Everything's great. The rest of the tomato plants, I plucked off those leaves. I didn't even need to do it. I thought some kind of fungus was present. No, it's fine. I'm going to hit it with humidity tonight. I'm going to feed them. Feed them. Not just dump water in there. Go around it. Real evenly with some warm water. And maybe take a stripe through the middle. Girls, don't drown it. Don't kill it. When you put a bunch of water in there, those cups, you got to squish, squish, squish. Watch the water trickle down. Now it's moist. It's so heavy. See, they're light right now because they're dying. They're thirsty. But does it look like it's dying to you? This ain't dying. Don't be afraid not to water them. I don't say starve them to death, but literally, you know, give it some time. I backed off of the lights a little bit, so I didn't like the spots, and I just put them in a general area. And then, you know, like I said, I'm going to build the tables. My husband's a master carpenter, so you're German, so he's going to come in and build me all these really cool tables for next to nothing. I've been collecting wood, by the way. Yeah, my neighbors are throwing 2x4s away. Grabbed him right out of the trash can. Hey, what are you doing? You know, they're just throwing money away. Ugh. And I found this pot. Check this out. Yeah, my neighbor threw it away. You gotta be resourceful. See this thing? That's their old trash can. Let's see how much they paid for it. $5. Found me a $5. Put some holes down there with the drill. Planter. Look at that. It's as big as my head. Man, you gotta be cool. You gotta be cool, be sharp on your feet. Don't get discouraged. I was bummed out. I was so scared last night. And I was like, no way, I'm going to the pros. Went right down there, they're having a big old festival. Put a lottery ticket in to win this big angel fountain, which I probably wouldn't use anyway. I'd probably barter it. Because I make kombucha, I make kimchi, I make all this stuff. So I tell people, when you bring me a mason jar, I'll give you pure kombucha. And I put my own fruit pure juices in there. And we trade. I trade scopies. I trade plants. I trade all kinds of stuff. I'm in the bartering business. So I don't do nothing for making money. I do this for the love of it. And I love it. It's an art. And when they throw those big words at me, I don't know what they're talking about. But it is hot in here. It's probably 20 degrees cooler outside. So I'm going to hit them with wind, get them nice and ventilated. I've been sturdying. Remember I showed you guys how I was sturdying those up. Keep that wind going. Keep it going. When you ain't got nothing else to do, everything's been watered, everything's done, hit them with wind, you know. And I left the wind in here for 30 minutes. Had fans going. I don't bend them over, but I hit them so that stalk will respond to the wind. So watering, wind, feed them. As soon as those tomatoes start to look a little bit strong, just start feeding them, which is this junk, okay? Because I don't know how to make the kelp tea. I don't have time for that right now. So I got to go this route. But it was $20. I probably saved like $500 in this garden just from stealing wood out of somebody's trash. Bins. I can't tell you how many people have thrown these things away. I've got so many over here. And seeds. Seeds free, all over the place. And I've spent very, very little money on this garden. I think I've invested $200. And I'm probably, who knows who I'm going to feed with all this. I don't know. It's just fun. I have a lettuce growing. I didn't even have lettuce seeds. Don't ask me what that is. It's got to be cabbage. There's no way that's lettuce because I didn't have the seed. All my seeds go in here. There ain't no lettuce in there. All there is Chinese cabbage. It's got to be some form of a cabbage. But I want to read that book. So I'm making this video because I had a sad Cinco de Mayo sad day. I was sitting there listening to the mariachis and nobody stopped and gave them respect. I was so hurt, started bawling. My father's Hispanic. He had a green thumb, so did my mother. He used to just grow stuff. Jalapenos. We dug up and tilled the garden every year. Didn't know what they were doing because I was a kid, but I think I'm doing that now as an adult. And all you guys that are viewing me and I'm viewing you, man, we're just like doing this whole like sharing, barter, fun stuff. You know, and I love it. I love, 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 love gardening. So that love will get you through it. And I haven't had anything die yet. Pray hard. I'm still letting people write on my wall. That thing's going to be full. Imagine in a couple years. Just going to be full. The hall, the walls, just be black Sharpie. I'm going to have to go get me different colored Sharpies. But I need to save a buck all the time. Because you don't know what you're going to need. And I got another bag of soil. Yeah. Until I learn how to make my own. So this is important to me. I think in every part of this, you're going to learn something. And save those coffee holes, coffee, planter. Save them. Tins, save them. You put your seeds in there. Put the lid on, nice seal. There's just so many resources. Look at your neighbor's trash. I do all the time. I'm looking in there. I mean, they're throwing it away. So I pulled 2x4s. Got a stack of 2x4s over here. Yeah, perfectly good wood. Brand new. Throw it away. Like it's scraps. Their trash is my treasure. So today on Sad Cinco de Mayo Day, it's the third, but this whole weekend we just, you know, I'm clean and sober so I don't drink, but we just, you know, Mexican party down. And without another female or male to go with, you know, it's at night, it's pretty dicey. They usually shut it down every year. They just shut it down. Gang warfare. So I'm not political, but no, I am political, huh? I am. But anyway, that's really important in the organicness of who you are. And the organicness of me, 1 year, well, probably not even 1 year, next year, I'll be making this. I know me. And next year, I'll have a better system. Next year, it'll be fluid. Next year, it won't be so much work. But the work is what makes you love it. Every single second you're working, you love it more. And I'm fortunate enough to not have to have a job so I can do this. So I'm excited. I'm hardcore. I'm ready to stake this stuff up. And I'm ready to make moves on my tomatoes I ain't never seen before. I'm ready to produce these chilies and pluck, pluck, pluck. And I can't wait for the first video where I have fruit. I can't wait for the first time I look at that fruit, turn on that iPad, which I still haven't learned to flip the camera, by the way, because I can't swipey swipe and do all the stuff they do. And who has time? I'm too busy paying attention to lighting and moving things. And there's just so much going on all the time. The expert guys, you know, they got it handled. But we're learning. We're in a learning curve. Keep it in the box of learning. So when they say heavy feeder, I don't know what they're talking about. When they say calcium, don't know what they're talking about. Nitrogen, don't know what they're talking about. All that stuff, I have to drive over there and talk to these people so they can say it to me and where I can learn it through pictures and things like that. So this book was a great find for $4. This was a good find at $20. And a bag of soil, $11. And it's just, it's worth it. It's worth it. So I'm not going to be sad today. I'm going to work in the garden and I'm going to turn some crazy Mexican music on and get righteous. But I thought I'd show you guys that stuff because I had never seen it. And I was panicking. You know, how dare my garden fall apart? It's fine, he said. He looked right at him and said, oh, you're good. So tomatoes are happy. Cabbage is happy. Chilies are happy. Cucumber, everything is just happy. The peas need feet. They need to feed. They're big movers, heavy feeders. So they're not peas. They're beans. I keep calling them peas. Those beans need food, extra food besides the soil and water. They need a food of nitrogen. Be careful, and calcium. Be careful. So just we'll figure it out. We'll get stuff off the internet and we'll make it cheaper. And every time I do, I'll make a video. And I love you guys. I got mad love and I got mad support here, and we're just going to make it better. Happy gardening. Wait, let me get my cardboard. It's a garden revolution, you guys. Grow your own food. Don't go to Walmart. Don't go to the organic store. Grow it. Grow it. Peace.